VBA. Ctrl+Enter or a macro way. Well, there's Mike G on the CSE. Billy J getting down with the VBA. Oh my, it's a Dueling Excel time. Stand by, it's a Dueling Excel time. La la, it's Dueling Excel time.
Hey, all right, it's time for another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This is our episode 166. Change color based on 1,000, 1999, and so on. All right, question sent in today. Melissa from YouTube, trying to write a formula to highlight a row based on the value of a cell. We're looking for between 1,000 and 2,000, 2,000 and 3,000, and so on. All right, so the first thing I thought of is, we're going to use some conditional formatting. I'm just going to build a little test formula out here, like Mike always does with his conditional formatting. And I want to break these things up. I'm guessing, so the et cetera there, right? We need to see everything between 1,000 and 2,000, 2,000, 3,000, 3,000, 4,000, and so on. So I want to take a look at this number divided by 1,000, but I want to see which bucket they land in. And the way I'm going to do that is to take the integer. So that way, this number will be 6.715, but the integer will just make it say 6, which means that it's in the 6,000 group. That little formula there is going to be part of the solution. And I'm interested in the min and the max. What's the range of numbers we have? So it looks like the min is 1614. I want to press Ctrl+Ditto, which brings me the exact same formula without changing the range. F2, home, right, change that to max. All right, so anything from one, so it looks like we're going to have about 9 different ranges. Conditional formatting would just be a real hassle here. So like the theme song says, here's Mr. Excel with the VBA way, Alt-T-M-S, if you've never used macros before, change from the top setting to the second setting. I see that this file is an XLSX, so file, save as. You can save it as the exact same file name, that's no hassle. But we need to change the file type to XLSM, right there. Click save. Now we're allowed to use macros in this file. So Alt F11, we will insert a new module. And I'll just call it sub color them. Final row is equal to cells. Rows.count, comma 1.end, xlup.row, and then for each, or for I equals, it looks like row 6 is where we start, the final row. All right, so inside that loop, we're going to say, we're going to check the value. So this value is in column D, and actually what we'll do is we'll do this val is equal to the int of cells I, comma 4, that's column D. Dot value divided by 1,000. So that's going to give us a number from 1 to 9 that's going to tell us what the color is going to be. So I have to assign 9 different colors, but actually I'm not going to assign 9 different colors. I'm going to make use of the theme color trick here. So I'm just going to come over here. We're going to record a quick macro that says how to theme color. Click OK. And the only thing I'm going to do is open this drop down, choose one of these theme colors, and choose not the top one, but I want to apply one of the percentages. So there's lighter 40%, and then stop recording. Alt F8 to take a look at that macro, how to theme color, edit, and we're going to copy all of that code. Control C, come back to our module, and paste it in. I love the macro recorder, for just getting little bits of code. So the macro recorder does it to the selection. I'm not going to do it to the selection. We're going to say with cells I, comma 1 dot resize 1, comma 4 dot interior. The pattern is solid. The pattern color, we don't even have a pattern. Theme color is accent 5. And then right here, the tint and shade. This is a number that has to range from minus 1 to 1. The negative numbers are very dark. The positive numbers get lighter and lighter. So let's say that this is going to be minus this val divided by 10, and then pattern tint and jade is 0. Next eye, there we go, actually, look at that. I was already thinking ahead, already put the next eye in, and I think we are ready to roll. So back here, we'll just do Alt F8 and say color them, click run. That is just a bit too dark, too dark. All right, so here, let's take that number and add maybe plus 0.5. And again, the range that we have here is negative 1 to positive 1. So this will make it run from negative 0.5 on up to positive 0.4. I'll just run it again from here. There we go. So now every single different band of thousands gets a different color. And you have to be careful, you know, that you're in this range here, otherwise you potentially would get an error. But at this point, it's late in the day, 8 o'clock, and I just don't have the energy to write 10 different conditional formatting statements. So VBA is the way to go. Mike, let's see what you have.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Oh my heavens, look at all that beautiful conditional formatting for the whole row with VBA. Now, when I read this, I didn't interpret it as, hey, you want a band for each one of the groups between the max and the min. But man, if you had to do that with a formula, I'm going to go over to this sheet right here. Man, that would be a lot of formulas. So I'm thinking that we're going to have some input cells here. And based on what we type here, it'll just highlight the row for that given category. So I'm just going to give the lower, we'll say 2,000. And then tab equals that cell plus 1,000. So that'll be our grouping, right? So right now, we should only highlight the entire row anytime it's between the lower and the upper. Now, when I'm doing this, I'm going to use conditional formatting and formulas. And since it's for the whole row, I'd like to build the formula off here to the side, copy it down, and see if I can get the patterns of trues and falses to work. Then I'll copy the upper left formula from the cell and paste it into the conditional formatting dialog box. Hey, there's two conditions, so I'm going to use the AND function. Hey, the AND function has to get two trues. And what is it? We're looking through this column, and we're going to make sure it's between the upper and the lower. Now, here's the trick. That formula is ultimately going to have to be pasted in a dialog box that goes from this cell all the way over and down. So we're always going to be looking at the cells, and we're going to have to lock the column but not the row. So I'm going to hit the F4 1, 2, 3 times. And we're going to ask a question, are you greater than or equal to the lower number, F4? That'll give us a true or false. That's that logical one right there, comma. We have a second condition, same number, F4, 1, 2, 3 times to lock the column but not the row. And this one I'm going to say less than the upper. Now, I don't want to have less than or equal to because right now, the 3,000 is on the upper end, but when I later type a 3,000 here, this will be 4,000, and I don't want to include that 3,000 both in the 2,000 to 3,000 and the 3,000 to 4,000. So F4 to lock that in all directions, close parentheses, Control Enter, and now I'm going to copy it over just four cells. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, all four cells will get a false, so no color, but check this out. By the way, I put this right next to the data set so I can just double click and send it down. I would never really do that because I like to keep my data sets within a row of empty cells all the way around. So I'm actually going to point to the edge and move this over here just for safety. Now, we can see right here, this gives us a true. And check it out. Check out. It's looking for that cell right there. It's looking at that number. Even though the formula is right here, it's going to be in that cell right there. So the whole row gets trues. Now, here's the trick. We go to the upper left corner, copy the formula in edit mode, Control C, Escape. Now we highlight, Control Shift, right arrow, down arrow. Now I'm going to scroll all the way up because I actually want to see that that's the active cell. That is the parallel cell to that formula. That active cell has to be the active cell because I copied it from the upper corner. Now I'm going to do Alt-HLN. That actually is in the Home Conditional Formatting New Rule. Alt-HLN. Arrow. Use a formula tab, Control-V. Now I'm going to go down and add some formatting. Fill, whatever it is, I don't know. I'll do yellow, click OK. And just like that, I've highlighted just the rows in this band. Now if I type 3,000 here, boom, I get a different set of bands. 5,000, boom, I get a different band of rows with conditional formatting. All right, throw it back to Mr. Excel.
Hey, great trick with the conditional formatting. Just one rule, because you figured that she was going to randomly want one band or the other. It's interesting how this really comes down to, it wasn't dueling Excel techniques, it was dueling, trying to guess what the person wanted from their question. Which brings up a shameless product plug here. Over this past weekend, I put together a new website, ExcelArticles.com. I needed a place, a responsive web design, to hold all of the videos that I had put up, recent Excel book, and then hot topics from the Mr. Excel message board. And as I was looking for these, it tended to be the items that had lots of responses. And again, that could just mean that it was an ambiguous question that got asked, and people out at Mr. Excel came up with a lot of different answers. So check this out. A lot of interesting reading out here. Works great on a phone or an iPad or a tablet or a PC, ExcelArticles.com. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. I want to thank Mike for that great answer. We'll see you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.